Good morning, dear students. Till last day, we were learning about civics, electoral politics. Now, we have to study a new lesson in geography, that is fourth lesson, climate. So, in this lesson, we have to study in detail about the climate. Before starting the lesson, I want to ask you, generally when we speak with our friends, what we say about the atmosphere condition of the day? We say, what is the climate today? Is it hot? The climate is hot, or weather is hot? What would be the right word to use? Is it climate or weather? To specifically say about today's climate, what we say generally is what you use, climate or weather? Just think over it. So you can see many times people use climate. But is it correct to use climate word to say about a particular day's state of atmosphere? Generally, we all people make mistake in that. It is not the word to use, climate, but it is weather. So when we speak about a particular day, or particular time, particular condition of weather at a particular moment or particular time, we have to say weather. But if we speak about 1 month, okay, the month or 2 months or 1 year, many years, what we generally we have to use climate. Here we cannot use the word weather, okay. So from this we can understand that there are some difference between weather and climate. So we have to now distinguish between weather and climate. So let us distinguish between these two. One is climate, another one is weather. So now I will explain you what is actually climate and what is actually weather. Okay. First point is that climate here in the sense, the sum total of weather conditions. Sum total of weather conditions we say climate. Weather in the sense, the state of atmosphere. State of atmosphere is weather. Okay. Second thing. So second point we have to say, climate which is over a large area. Climate does not include, does not limited to particular area, but it includes large area. While weather we specifically say about particular place or particular area. Over a particular area, weather we say. But for large area, we say climate. Climate of India. India is big, right? So, here we say climate. But weather, weather of our particular place, that we say the word is weather. Third thing, climate is for a long period of time. So it is for a long period of time. 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 5 years, many more years, we say climate. But at a point of time, at any particular point of time, for example, in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon, we say weather. What is the weather in the morning? So, what was the weather in the afternoon yesterday? We say about the weather. But for a long period of time, we say the word, that is climate. So, here we have distinguished between climate and weather. So, again, sum total of weather conditions, that is climate, state of atmosphere, that is weather, over a long, large area, that is climate, but at a particular point of time, weather. Then, long period of time, that is climate, but in a particular or any point of time, that is weather. So these are the two important terms you have to study. So from now onwards, we will correctly speak what is the weather today. We cannot use what is the climate. Okay. This is the first thing. Generally, the climate or the state of atmosphere is different. In different places it differ, or it is different in different places. Somewhere it will be hot, somewhere it will be cloudy, but somewhere it might be rainy, somewhere there will be sunny day. So same way, these situation or the state of atmospheric conditions, it differ from place to place and time to time. So generally, climate word or India's climate, mainly we have to study here about India's climate. Before that, generally we can see there are mainly three important seasons or three important climatic situation or climatic seasons. What are they? Summer, winter and rainy season, right? So now it's going on the rainy season. After that we experience the winter, then after that summer. So this is the general condition, okay, in India. And when this state of atmosphere, we cannot see other countries. Somewhere we can see, we cannot see rainy season as a particular climatic condition in many parts of the countries. Because India is unique, or India we experience rainy season. But other countries, it is not a season. Okay. This is the difference from our country to other countries in the climate. And first, the word we have to relate to the climate of India is monsoon. So India's climate is monsoon type. Okay. Our climatic condition is monsoon type. Monsoon word is derived from monsoon. Monsoon. It means the climate or seasonal variations. So monsoon is the word from which the monsoon word is derived. Monsoon word, which is derived from the Arabic word, that is monsoon, that means season. So monsoon in the sense season. So monsoon can be defined as the seasonal reversal of wind direction during a year. So during a year, seasonal reversal of wind direction in during a particular year is known as monsoon. Now monsoon, or this season, monsoon season, or the seasonal changes, which depend upon two elements. So season is depending upon two important elements. What are the two important elements? First one is known as temperature, second one is known as precipitation. Now with example we can study about the two elements. So two elements decide the season. What are they? Temperature and precipitation. Temperature, if we study about temperature, the temperature in, for example, in the summer month, temperature is very high. Okay. So in the summer season, temperature increases. In Rajasthan, especially in the desert, temperature is very high. Some parts of Rajasthan experience 50 degree, more than 50 degree Celsius temperature. While the some places in Jammu and Kashmir, for example, Pahalgam, in the same summer season, it experience 15 degree Celsius. So we can see the difference. Somewhere it is 50 degree, but somewhere it is 15 degree. Same way, we can see the temperature in the night. So in the daytime and night time, the temperature increases somewhere and decreases. So somewhere there are no changes. For example, in Rajasthan, temperature in the daytime is high, but night time it becomes very less. So night time Rajasthan experiences a very less temperature, while some of the place, for example, Andaman and Nicobar, Kerala, etc., we can see there is no difference between day and night, nighttime temperature. There is no difference between daytime and nighttime temperature. But in Rajasthan, it is vast difference we can experience. Daytime it is very high, but at nighttime it reduces to very less temperature. Same way in the winter season, if we see Jammu and Kashmir, for example, Dras in Jammu and Kashmir, where it becomes minus degree, but somewhere in the same winter season in the coastal region, for example, Thiruvananthapuram, where it is only 22 degrees Celsius. So we can see there are a lot of changes in the same country from one place to another place. Somewhere daytime temperature and nighttime temperature, there is a vast difference, but some places there is no difference. And some places in the summer month, we can see very high temperature, some places the same summer month it is not that much. Winter same way, it is very less temperature, it reduces to minus, but some parts there are no such variation. So these, we can say that it is one of the element or it is one of the factor which decide the season of a place or of the particular place. So temperature is very important in the analysis of season or climate. Another thing is precipitation, in the sense it can be snowfall or it can be rainfall. In the mountain regions, for example Himalayas, it experience snowfall, but other parts of the country there are no snowfall. So precipitation, here it can be snowfall or rainfall. We can see now about the rainfall. If we see in Meghalaya, 400 centimeter, more than 400 centimeter rainfall Meghalaya receives. But some places like Ladakh, then Rajasthan, etc., where rainfall is very less. Okay, so we can see there are lot of difference between the rainfall, okay, receiving of rainfall in the rainy season. Some parts it is more than 400 centimeter, but somewhere it will be only 20 centimeter, 10 centimeter, etc. it receives. So there are so precipitation is another important factor to study about the climate of a place. Now we can see that these all variations take place according to the place and according to the time. Okay, so temperature and precipitation are the key factors to determine the climate of a place. Now let us study about the climatic controls, or what are the factors which decides the climate of a place. So next, now we have to study about the climatic controls, or what are the factors which control the climate of a place. Okay, in this there are six factors are there to control the climate of a place. So what are the six factors that we have to study here? First important factor is altitude. Altitude means height of a place. So altitude, how it determine the, or how it is a factor of to decide the climate of a place. If we see the mountains, when we are below the mountain ranges or on the surface of the earth, or the below the mountain ranges, the temperature is high than the higher mountain altitudes. So when we go up in the mountain ranges or mountainous areas, the air becomes less dense and temperature also reduces. So atmosphere become less dense and temperature reduces if we go from below the mountain to, if we go to the mountain places, we can experience the difference in temperature. During the summer season, we experience extreme hot in the plains. But if we go to the mountain ranges or mountainous places like Mahabaleshwar, Ooty, or Himalayas, we can see that there is less temperature compared to the plains. Why? Because in the mountain ranges or in the mountainous areas or higher altitudes, atmosphere becomes less dense and temperature also reduces. That is why people during the summer season, we like to go to the mountain areas, right? Or the hill stations, because temperature is reduced or temperature is less over there. So this is the first factor which decide the climate of a place, that is altitude. If the place is heighted, temperature will be less. Or if the place is less heighted, less altitude, temperature will be more. Second factor we have to study, that is about the latitude. Latitude as the important factor to decide the climate of a place. How the latitude decide the climate? First thing is that the earth has important parallels of latitude. You have studied it in your earlier classes. 0 degree equator as the biggest latitude. Then Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Arctic Circle, Antarctic Circle, North Pole, South Pole, right? So in this we can say when the curvature of this earth, due to the curvature of this earth, in the equatorial region, direct sunlight, it reaches direct sunlight over this equator or over this equatorial region. Both the sides of this equator, it receives direct sunlight. Okay? And that is why equatorial region are extremely hot and humid. But North Pole and South Pole, it is far away, it receives slanting sunlight. So, when the earth rotates, these two poles, which is due to the curvature of this earth, the South Pole and North Pole receive slanting sunlight. That is why it is temperature is less over there, or very less. Temperature is very less. So, latitude is one of the important factors which decide the temperature of a place. Due to this, equator, it is one of the latitude where direct sunlight reaches and it is extremely hot and humid. But both these poles, which is due to the curvature of this earth, the North Pole and South Pole, which is far away and which receives slanting sunlight, and the temperature is very less over there. So this is the second factor, that is latitude. Third important factor, that is pressure and wind system. Pressure, atmospheric pressure and wind system, that completely depend upon the temperature of particular place. Okay, temperature of particular place or atmospheric pressure and wind system both depend upon temperature. So this is another important factor which decide the climate of a place. Fourth factor, that is distance from the sea. How distance from the sea affect the climate of a place, or it become the factor of climate of a place. For example, the places which are near to the sea, coastal areas, that areas or that places are, the climate is, or the atmospheric condition, that is moderated by the presence of ocean or sea. So moderate climate these areas experience, or the places near to the ocean or sea which experience a moderate climate, not too much hot, not too much cold. But the places which are far away from the ocean or sea, which experience an extreme climate. For example, you can see Bangalore, which is far away from sea. So that Bangalore place, which experience comparatively high temperature during the summer season and less temperature during the winter season. If we compare Guhagar is a coastal area, that during the summer season it is moderate if we compare with Bangalore. That means around 35 degrees Celsius, 38 degrees Celsius it receives. But Bangalore, comparatively, if we compare it, the temperature increases there. And during the winter season, this particular place, Guhagar, or the area which is near to the sea coast, which experiences a moderate climate, but far away, interior of the of a particular place, far away, that particular places experience a very less temperature during the winter season. This is because of the presence of sea or presence of ocean. So coastal areas are moderated by the sea or ocean. Now, fifth important factor is ocean current. You have studied ocean current in the previous classes. Ocean current, or the current which generates inside the ocean currents. So mainly there are warm currents and cold currents. Warm currents, where the warm current passes, that places near to the warm current, which is influenced by the warm current and the make the place warmer. And the places which are, or the cold current which pass through the places, that places are influenced by the cold current and it makes the place cooler. So places which are influenced by the cold current becomes cooler. Places which are influenced by the warm current become warmer. So this way, ocean currents also ocean current also have some important role to decide the climate of a particular place. Last one, that is relief. Relief means geographical conditions or physiographic conditions. For example, mountain ranges like Himalayas, Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats, etc. These are mountain ranges which obstruct the rain-bearing clouds. So the Himalayas, we can say, which obstruct the snow from the Tibetan plateau. Snowfall or very extreme cold wind is obstructed, and that places receives a precipitation of snowfall. But here in the Western Ghat, it obstructs the rain-bearing clouds which receives from the southern ocean, and it is obstructed and we get a rainfall. So mountain ranges act as a barrier. It become a barrier to obstruct the wind. So that particular places which receives places which are in the sides of the mountain ranges which receives rainfall. So and Himalayas, we can see it receives that, all places which receives snowfall. So same way, this is relief. Because of the relief means high mountain ranges become the barrier, or it act as a barrier to precipitate over there. So these are the important six factors which affect the climate of a place. First, we have studied about altitude, height of a place. In that, we have studied about mountains. Second one, that is latitude. We have studied about the sun's rays passing to the earth in different way. Somewhere it is directly and somewhere it is slanting. So latitude. Third one, that is pressure and wind system, depend upon the temperature of a place. Fourth one, we have studied about the distance from the sea. Fifth one is ocean current, and sixth one is relief. These are the important major six factors which influence the climate of a place.